Today, we're going to show you how you can use just your phone as a webcam. No need to purchase an app, and it will work with iPhone, Android, Windows, Mac, OBS, you name it. Not only that, but if you stick around, I will show you how to make it work with Zoom and Skype. Let's do this. Hi everyone and welcome to Pal to Tech. In the past, I've shown you how you can turn your phone or professional camera into a webcam using an app. The problem was that it relied on having to purchase an app and hope that it would work on your device. So today, let's not deal with any of these apps. Here's how you do it. So first, you need a free copy of OBS for either your PC or your Mac. Go to obsproject.com and download the free program. Once you have it downloaded, go ahead and install it. It's a great program that allows you to share your desktop, live stream, hold online meetings, and so much more. Once you open it up, you may see a dialog box that looks like this. You can go ahead and just exit out in the upper right-hand corner. It may look a little different on your setup, but overall, it should look very similar to this. Okay, now that you have OBS installed, the next thing you need to do is tell OBS that you're going to be using your smartphone as a webcam. Now, for this demo, I've got plenty of smartphones that I can use, but I'm gonna choose the Samsung Galaxy S7 because it's old, it's falling apart, and the battery kind of expanded. Look at this, blowing out the back of the phone. So what you need to do is on the device that you want to use for your webcam, you need to go to vdo.ninja, spelled just like this, vdo.ninja. When you get there, you'll see a screen that looks just like this. Go ahead and choose the choice that says add a camera to OBS. If it asks you for permissions, allow it. You'll see a screen that kind of looks like this. And at this point, go ahead and tap start. And once you start it, you'll see an address in the top left corner of the screen in green. You see that right there? That's the address you're going to need to put into OBS. So you could tap the little paperclip just like that and copy it to the clipboard, and then you could email it to yourself or just write it down. Either way, get that address, and then the final thing you're gonna do is go back into OBS and we'll set it up. Inside of OBS, you wanna go to where it says sources, you see that? And click the little plus, and you are going to add what's called a browser. Boom. You can name it anything you want. I'm gonna call it iPhone webcam. Click OK, and you'll get to a screen that looks like this, that has sort of this OBS logo. Remember that address I told you about? This is where you're going to put it, right here. Then for width, I recommend you put 1920, and for height, 1080. Make sure you tick the box that says control audio via OBS. Now it's kind of hard to see, but there is a scroll bar right here. Scroll down and make sure that refresh browser when scene becomes active is ticked, just like that. At this point, you're done. Go ahead and click OK. Have a look at this. Have a look at this, it worked. Check it out. I am streaming from this phone through that VDO Ninja all the way into OBS. And I can use this in OBS as a video source for whatever else I wanna do. If I wanna stream, if I wanna add another camera angle, whatever, it's perfect for that. And it's also capturing audio from the mic on the device itself. And you can control it from here, see? Now I'll talk softly. Now I'll talk loudly. You see that? You can control it using this slider. And this is great if you want to do a live stream where you have different cameras, or you want to have your desktop, you want to share your desktop in the background. So look at this. I can demo stuff on the screen as well as have my picture right in the lower right corner of the screen. And the camera that comes with your phone is so much better than the camera usually with your laptop. And the great thing about the phone is that you can switch the cameras and use the rear-facing camera as well. Check it out. Look at that. I could walk around this place with this. Yeah, right? See that? Much better using the camera on the phone than the camera on the laptop. Now, Video Ninja also gives you some options here. You can do things like mute the mic, switch cameras, turn off the video, and so forth. But in most cases, you don't need to change anything and you can get up and running right away. No app was installed on this phone whatsoever. How about taking this one step further? What about using it with Zoom or Skype? Well, it turns out that you can do that, but there's a few things you need to do. First, make sure that you've upgraded to the latest versions of Zoom or Skype. It will not work with the earlier versions. The next thing you want to do is go into your OBS software. Now, you see on the right-hand side where it says Start Virtual Camera. You see that right there? Go ahead and click on that. And what that means is that OBS is going to use your phone as a virtual webcam so that other programs like Zoom or Skype can recognize it as one of your installed webcams. Okay, now that that's running, go ahead and open up Skype or Zoom. I'm gonna use Zoom for this demo. In the video section, you will have an area where you can choose your camera. Have a look at that. OBS virtual camera. I'm gonna go ahead and choose that. Oh, and it got so much better. So now I'm using my smartphone in Zoom through OBS, and I haven't installed a single app on the smartphone. Now, there is something you have to consider, and that is audio. Right now, by doing it this way, the audio is being picked up by the mic on the laptop. But what if your laptop was across the room or further away, and you wanted to use the microphone built into your smartphone? How would you make that work? Here's the problem. If you go into audio and you choose an audio source, look at that, see? It's not there. So what I would recommend is first try it where you're using the mic on the laptop. That might work out just great for you. And if so, you're done and you're ready to go. However, if you do need or want to use the mic that's on the smartphone, here's how you do that. You need to go to vb-audio.com/cable/index.htm. I will have a link to that down below in the description of this video. This is completely free of charge. You will not need to make any purchases. Simply choose your operating system, and in this case, I'm going to choose Windows. Once you've downloaded it, you'll see it's a zip file. You can go ahead and extract it out so that you see it in its own folder, just like this. From there, go ahead and open it up and click on Setup. You see that right here? If nothing happens, that means you need to click on the Setup 64-bit one, and that looks just like this. So depending upon your machine, you're either gonna click Setup or you're gonna click Setup 64. And if you see this screen, you should be good to go. Go ahead and click Install Driver, Install, and you'll get the successful message like that. The next thing you need to do is go back into OBS Studio. There is a small setting change that you need to make. Inside of OBS, you'll see your audio meters for your various audio devices. Look for the one that was from the smartphone that you had connected earlier. Go ahead and click on the little gear icon. You see that right there? And choose Advanced Audio Properties. And you should see something that looks like this. The setting change that you need to make is for the device that you had set to use as your webcam. In this case, I use my iPhone. And over here where it says audio monitoring, you see that? Change this so that it says monitor and output. You see that right there? Then go ahead and click close. Now go and open Zoom or Skype. And as always, don't forget to be sure that your virtual camera is turned on in OBS. Now that we're back in Zoom, let's go to our audio settings. In your audio settings right here, you should see that choice that we talked about earlier, VB Audio Virtual Cable. Have a look at that. It's working now. You see that? It's able to pick up the audio that's coming from your smartphone, not from any other source. So for this next demo, I'm going to show you how you can run your own online meeting room with multiple participants without using Zoom or Skype or any kind of an app or anything else. I'm going to use a Mac Mini for this demonstration. A Mac Mini does not come with any kind of a camera, so I will need to hook in my iPhone using the techniques I showed you earlier in the video. So the first thing I do is open up a browser and go to vdo.ninja, and I'll see a screen that looks like this. I'm going to go ahead and create a room. You see that right there? And I'm going to name the room after me, right? I'm not even going to require a password for this demo, but if you're doing this for real, you probably should require a password for security. I'm going to tick this box right here because I'm a performer. I'm going to just say default for everything else, and I'm going to enter the room's control center. And that's it. I've just set up the meeting room, okay? So now, if you look right here, it has created a special link, vdo.ninja/ and then a question mark, and then room equals, and then the name of the room. So I'm gonna go ahead and use one of my smartphones to join that room so that I can use it as a webcam. Okay, so I'm gonna add this particular camera to OBS and make sure that Start Virtual Camera is selected in OBS. And to get the best iPhone camera, I'm gonna go ahead and change it to the rear-facing camera. Okay, let's get this on a tripod here. Okay, here we go. I've got one camera. I am the host of the meeting. And what I'm going to be doing is telling all of my other friends who I want to have join the meeting the special link that they need to open up a browser and go to join the meeting. They do not need any app installed. They don't need anything else to make this work. So now I'm going to go ahead and add some additional participants to this meeting room so you can see how it works. All of these participants are only going to be using their smartphones with no additional apps or anything else installed. Here we go. Okay, the first one right here is going to be Thanos. And I'm going to go to vdo.ninja. And I'm going to click Join Room with Camera. Okay, that's Thanos. Now let's add Gear Iguana. Okay, we'll do one more camera. Okay, headed back into the studio now. Let's do one more, an iPad Pro. Let's ratchet this up a notch. Okay, same as the others, open up vdo.ninja and enter the room name that was created. Make sure you spell the room name correctly. Okay, joining room on the iPad. Okay, here goes. Okay, so I have four smartphones plus one iPad Pro, all of them connected in an online meeting and none of them using any kind of apps or special software or anything. It was all done through a web browser. How cool is that? Now, there were a lot of additional settings in both OBS and vdo.ninja that I didn't have time to cover today. Settings like how to improve the video or switch the cameras around and more options for hosting meetings and so forth. As of the date of this video, there is absolutely no charge to use this service. I also want to point out that I have nothing to do with this service. I'm not involved with them in any way. I'm just a user that stumbled across it, thinks it's really cool, and wanted to share it with all of you. Well, I hope you found this video helpful, or at least entertaining, and if you did, be sure to give it the like and subscribe. I will see all of you in another video again very soon. Take care.